the last lecture, we saw two options for calculating the coefficient K when computing safety stocks. One takes into account the desired service level expressed in terms of probability to avoid a stockout. The other one, instead, refers to the desired RM fee rate, which is the ratio between the quantity available in the warehouse and the overall quantity demanded. In this lecture, we are going to take into account the case of the RM fee rate. The process is structured into three main steps. First, set the RM fee rate using the first formula showed in the picture. Second, derive IK, which is the loss integral, using the second formula appearing in the picture, whose demonstration will be soon analyzed. Third, read K from the table of the loss integral. Now, we will go through the demonstration of the formula which links the RM fee rate and IK based on the application of the loss integral in order to better understand where it comes from. The expected annual units in stockout can be derived multiplying the expected number of units in stockout during the delivery lead time times the number of orders in a year. And the number of orders in a year is given by the annual demand divided by the order quantity, Q. The resulting RM fee rate formula is thus shown in the picture. The RM fee rate is then 1 minus the ratio between the amount of units in stockout during the lead time and Q. Once we have understood that the RM fee rate depends on the unit in stockout during the lead time, the first step to be done consists into calculating the unit in stockout during the lead time. They can be computed through the integral shown in the picture. Let's see more in detail three elements needed to come up with this formula. First, we have to compute the expected number of units in stockout during the lead time in case the demand is exactly equal to Y. This value is found as the difference between the actual value of the demand during the lead time, Y, and the reorder point. I remind you that the reorder point is the sum between the expected demand during the lead time and the safety stock level. Second, this value is then multiplied by Fy, which is the probability to have a demand exactly equal to Y. Third, since there is a stock out only when the actual demand Y is higher than the reorder point, we integrate the found function from the reorder point to the infinite. Once the integral has been defined, the following step consists in switching the function of the demand to a standard normal distribution. This can be done subtracting the average value, that in this case is the expected demand during the lead time, and dividing the result by the standard deviation, that in this case is the standard deviation of the demand during the lead time. This step is performed for all the terms of the integral. In order to standardize the lower limit of the integral, the safety stock should be expressed as the product between the value k and the standard deviation of the demand during the lead time. As shown in the picture, while standardizing the normal distribution, the expression becomes exactly equal to k. Then we move to the expected number of units in stockout, the terms between the parentheses. Standardizing the value of the actual demand y minus the average demand during the lead time divided by the standard deviation of the demand during the lead time, Y results to be the sum between the expected demand during the lead time and the product of the new variable Z and the standard deviation of the demand during the lead time. Putting this Y formula, depending on Z, in the expression between parentheses, the expression, due to the simplifications, becomes the one shown in the picture, the product between Z minus K and the standard deviation during the lead time. The third term to be standardized is the F function depending on Y that becomes a new G function depending on the new variable Z. Putting all the new three standardized terms together, the new integral in Z is the one shown in the picture. If we define then IK value as shown in the picture, the new expression of the annual units in stockout can be derived as a product between IK, and the standard deviation of the demand during the lead time. If we use the RMP rate formula previously illustrated, and we replace the value of the unit stock out during the lead time with the expression we have just found, the link between the RMP rate and the IK is identified as shown in the picture. Once the demonstration behind the formula has been illustrated, we now see how to apply it in order to derive the value of K. First, the IK has to be derived and shown in the picture. Second, the IK value obtained has to be found in the loss integral table. The corresponding K value is the one associated to the desired service level, and thus the one that will be used to compute the safety stock. Now, I will show you an example on how to compute the safety stocks in the case the service level is expressed in terms of desired RMP rate. Let's consider the same input data of the example seen during the previous lecture, but knowing that the OQ is 110 pieces, we are indeed considering the reorder point model, and the objective RMP rate is 98%. The composite standard deviation of the demand during the lead time does not change since it is not affected by the service level, and it is thus equal to 25.3 pieces. The first step to find the K is the computation of the IK. Using the formula we previously saw, it is found as the ratio between two parts. At the numerator, 1 minus the RMP rate, which is 0.98%, multiplied by the order quantity, that in this case is the economic order quantity, 110 pieces. At the denominator, the composite sigma, 25.3. The result is then 0.08695. Then we have to look for the value of the IK in the normal loss integral table. If our value of IK is 0.08695, the coefficient to be selected is K equal to 1. Finally, we multiply 1 and 25.3, obtaining the value of the safety stock, in this case 25.3 pieces. The example we have just seen is referred to the reorder point model. What happens if we instead consider the periodic review one? The differences are two. First, the quantity to be considered is not Q or EOQ anymore, but it is the average order quantity given by the product between the expected demand in a certain period and the order interval of T periods. Second, the composite standard deviation has to consider not only the replenishment lead time, but also the time interval T. In conclusion, in this lecture, we have seen two things. First, how to compute the K that corresponds to the desired service level in terms of item fee rate. And second, the demonstration of the formula that links the item fee rate and the IK.